Hi, Chrisman Backlight here, and today I wanted to show you some of the new features we're bringing to the asset player in Iconik. We really wanted to make collaboration in Iconik feel even bigger and bolder than it was before, and make it easier for you to collaborate with your clients and colleagues when reviewing all the great work that you've been doing. So, to kick things off, let's jump into an asset. This looks like a good one. As you can see, straight away, you've got a much larger window here. We're really making your work the focus of the media review experience, and this player window is also responsive. It will adjust to the available space that you give it. So in giving everything more space, we're making it easier for everybody to see the media, really see those details, and give your work the attention that it deserves. If I open up the comments, you can see here that we've tweaked the UI a little bit. We've moved the comments section that used to be below the media, and we've put it underneath the comments panel on the right. We've done this for a number of reasons, partly to optimize the available screen real estate that you have, but it also just feels a little bit more natural to write your notes underneath the panel where they appear. So let's add a quick note. To put things into context, let's compare this against the old media player in Iconik. You can see here that the experience is much smaller. The comments bar takes up a whole bunch of space at the bottom there. And if we go back to the new player, everything is much bolder and your work really has much more focus. These UI changes aren't the only changes we've made to the new Iconik media player. We've also added some really cool new features designed to make it easier for you to compare and contrast the work that you've been doing. So, let's jump into a new asset to look at compare mode. Let's find a nice asset. This one looks good. So you can see at the top here, we have multiple versions of this asset. Let's say we're working with a client and they want to see the changes between two of those versions. That's now really easy to do with compare mode. So let's activate compare mode. And let's say we want to compare version 5 with version 2. Now you can see here, we've got this really easy side-by-side comparison. It's really easy to look at one version of the asset and then at the other and make those contrasts and comparisons between the two. But this side-by-side comparison mode isn't the only option available. We've also included a wipe mode. And here you can see you've got this wipe that you can move and control around the screen to compare the assets in a slightly different way. And there's one more compare mode feature too, which is overlay. So with overlay, what we've done is we've got one version placed on top of another with adjustable opacity. So if I move this slider, we can see the differences from one version to the next. This mode can be really powerful if you're identifying changes in the edit, such as movement and timing. So let's have a quick look at another version of the asset, which has a different zoom and a bit of different timing. If we move the slider over to the left here, we can see version 5 more clearly, or if we leave it in the middle, we can see a blend of the two. And again, it just makes it so much easier to spot variations or changes in an asset version, and that can be really handy when you want to show clients the subtle changes you've made to work that may not necessarily show up as clearly on a side-by-side comparison or using the wipe feature. The next feature I'd like to show you today is the new zoom mode. So let's jump out of this asset, close compare mode, and let's have a look at this one here. Now with the new zoom mode, using your mouse scroller, it's really easy to zoom in, pan around, and really get up close and in detail with those aspects of the image you really want to pay attention to. Let's say we want to add an annotation to this image. Let's add one now. You can see here we've also added some options to change line width. I'll use this one here for the time being. Let's pick the circle tool and a new color. And let's give this toucan a monocle. Now, if I zoom out or zoom in, you can see that the annotation stays locked in the right place and at the right scale. You've got some other zoom options down here. You can see we can toggle between fitting the media to the window, going to actual size, or using some of these preset zooms here. Let's jump back to actual size for a true 1:1 resolution. The next thing I'd like to show you today is dynamic watermarking. Iconik's new dynamic watermark overlay feature is designed to enhance the security of your shared video and image content by adding visible, personalized watermarks like the one you can see here. Of course, Iconik already offers many security features and limits access to assets with features like access control lists, but we wanted to take things one step further and offer even more solutions to secure your content against potential leaks. So, with Iconik's dynamic watermark overlay, you can now automatically apply this visible watermark to your videos and images when sharing them externally. And the watermark can include things like the recipient's email, IP address, and other identifying information, making it a powerful deterrent against unauthorized sharing. Now there's one more feature I wanted to show you today, and that is the new marker timeline lanes we've added to the review player UI. So to put this in context, let's have a look at the old UI again. Here at the bottom, you can see the timeline representing comments made by users. But this clip also has some time-based metadata and subclips. So let's open those now. And you can see as I've opened those panels and that information, more pips have appeared on the timeline representing the time-based metadata and the subclips. But in this old player, it's a little bit difficult to differentiate what's what, and things can start to feel a little bit cluttered on that timeline. So we've addressed this with the new player UI. Let's go back to the new player, select a new asset, and open up the comments, time-based metadata, and the subclips. Now you can see in the new review player, we've made things much clearer by adding separate lanes for comments, subclips, and time-based metadata. You can see how this makes it much easier to navigate your assets and see precisely what's been added and where on those assets. Let's close these panels and play this asset on a loop because it's quite nice to look at. And that's a look at the new Iconik Media Player in action. We hope that with these new UI changes and features, you can have even more productive interactions with your colleagues and your clients in Iconik. And this is just the beginning of our renewed focus on media review and collaboration in Iconik. There's going to be a lot more to come in this space, especially following our acquisition by Backlight, and with some of the experience of the minds behind media review solutions like Cinesync and F-Track on our team. So stay tuned for those exciting updates, and thank you for watching.